Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Our Reverend Antiphon, let my prayer come into your presence. Incline your ear to my cry for help, O Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. My brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate together these sacred mysteries, let us first take a moment. We call to mind our sin, and we ask for God's forgiveness.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You're seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, this is our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Watch as I'm a man. took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. Five of them were foolish, and five were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out and meet him." Then all the virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish one said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went to the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
So some of the early church was curious, what's going to happen to them? They're dead. And so Paul wrote, and this is the first letter, the first writing in the New Testament, Paul wrote to the church of Thessalonica, and he said to them, "Those who die will also rise." But Jesus is coming back. We know not the day nor the hour, but those who have died in Christ will rise again. He described it in the sense that when Christ comes again, they will rise up, and then we will follow. So do not weep for those who have died. You know, we're coming to the end of our liturgical year. We are coming to the end of the year. And especially in this month of November, we have a way of remembering those who have gone before us. We have names inscribed upon the altar of our dead beloved ones, and we keep them in prayer. But Jesus said too, "You do not know the day nor the hour when the Son of Man will come," either calling each of us individually or calling us all collectively. But Jesus will come again. And he tells this particular parable in the gospel to remind us that we must be ready. He describes it in the sense of this wedding going on, and the bridegroom is coming to meet the bride. The bridegroom is Christ. And the bridegroom is Christ, and the bride is the church. And these virgins go out and wait for the bridegroom to come. And And some are wise, they bring extra oil because they know not during the night when the bridegroom will come. And there are some that are not prepared. Some are not prepared. And so they don't have enough oil in their lamps, and their lamps go dim. And so they have to go to the marketplace to get some more oil. And when they get to the wedding feast, the doors are already locked. So the message that Jesus was trying to portray in this parable is that we know not the day nor the hour when we will be called to give an account of our life. We know not the day nor the hour, so we must be prepared. Now, especially right at this time, it's a year since I lost my own sister. She was very dear to me. And she said to me at the beginning of November last year, when the oncologist had suggested to her she might want to see a psychiatrist, because the oncologist knew that there was nothing more he could do for her. And she looked at him and she said, "Why? I have my faith." And then when I was with her the last time, and when she was murdered, she said to me, "You know, if I wake up tomorrow, good. If I don't wake up tomorrow, I know where I'm going to be." She was right. If you wake up tomorrow, good. If you don't wake up tomorrow, do you know where you're going to be? I don't mean just in bed. I mean, do you know where you're going to be if you don't wake up tomorrow? We need to be prepared. We know not the day or the hour when we will be called to give an accounting of our life, or when we will all be called collectively. The Boy Scouts have a motto: be prepared. We must be like those wise virgins, ready just in case, because we know not when we will be called to give an account of our life. Are you ready? Are you ready? And if not, why not? If you wake up tomorrow, good. If you don't wake up tomorrow, do you know where you're going to be? I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. who is gracious and kind to hear us as we pray.
That the dying may look to Christ with hope and infinite trust, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sick and for all those unable to attend Mass today, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, especially for James and Elizabeth Burns, and retired General Camilo P. Castellon Living, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our end to the war overseas and peace in our world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the souls named, placed upon our altar during the month of November, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all the intentions spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks and praise for hearing us, confident that you will answer us, because we make our prayer through Christ Jesus, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer to you. Food of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer to you. Food of the vine, the work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Bring my brothers and sisters that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness of his hours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing to him of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith we proclaim. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by his body and blood and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose past intercession, in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, O Lord, we pray, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Leonard, our Archbishop, his coadjutor Christopher, your assistant Juan, with the order of bishops and all the clergy and all the people, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. And your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters, too. And to all who are pleasing to you with their passing in this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom of God and glory is yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my garment, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you.
Jesus, now minister the body of Christ to his brothers and sisters. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. I plead at heart, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters, he leads me. Let us pray. Nourished by the sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I want to thank you. Thank you for sharing this Eucharist with me this morning and for allowing me to share my priesthood with you. The Lord be with you.
Yes.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. And do have a good week, everyone. Prayer for vocations to the priesthood, and remember in a particular way Daniel Hackentrace, a member of this parish. Heavenly Father, you have created us for a definite purpose. We grant us the grace to know the path you have planned for each of us in this life, and to respond to the generous yes. Make my parish, my home, and my heart a fruitful ground for your gift of vocations for the priesthood of Jesus Christ. May our young men respond to your call with courage and zeal. Stir among them a desire and a strength to be good and holy priests. We make our prayers and priests and vocations to you, Father, in the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord. Mary, Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
St. Joseph, Patron of our Archdiocese,
pray for us.
Blessed Michael, forgive me,
pray for us.
Have a good week, everyone.